Hi friends, today we are going to discuss the introduction part of the computer graphics. So in computer graphics, we need to understand what is a computer graphic. A computer graphics is used by the computer system to display the image onto the screen. That means the image can be created and the image can be manipulated by the computer graphics. So now, without computer graphics nowadays, we can't imagine any field, because of in all the video related or any concept oriented, even in the automation process depends on the computer graphics itself, because nowadays the usage of computer graphics is more compared to the remaining concepts related to the computer science. So this computer graphics majorly discussed how to draw the image onto the screen, how to display the image onto the screen. That is the first thing, how to display the image onto the screen, and second part, how to create an image onto the screen and how to manipulate the image onto the screen. So basically these are the three important aspects. So we need to understand the first one, how the image can be displayed onto the screen. The second one, how to create the image onto the screen. The next thing is how to manipulate the image onto the screen. So before we discuss these three important issues, first we need to understand what is a computer graphics. So computer graphics is used the computer system to create and manipulate the images onto the screen. So here the two things are operated. One is creation of the image and second one is the manipulations of the image. The manipulations are nothing but some of the operations which are performed on the image or the any picture which is displayed onto the screen. So here we can understand the computer graphics in two ways. So one is the first one is the non-interactive computer graphics, and second one is the interactive computer graphics. So the non-interactive computer graphics are the computer graphics which are able to take the communication in one way. So non-interactive in the sense only the one way communication is taken by the user from the graphics. That means the graphics and the user takes only the one way communication. The example of the non-interactive computer graphics is nothing but the television. So the television is taking the one way communication to the user only. So whatever the image or whatever the video or the anything which is played on the television, so the user can view the only things on the display devices, and there is no manipulation. That means the total control will not take by the user itself. So everything is operated only in the manual. So that is a few operations like switch on the television, switch off the television, and changing the channel, only the those simple operations. But we are not taking any manipulations of operations on the television. So that is an non-interactive computer graphics. And interactive computer graphics are nothing but the two-way communication. That means we are the users, we take some of the manipulations by the some of the operations. That means we can do the two-way communication. The two-way communication is possible from the graphics to user, user to graphics. So graphic in the sense whatever the image which is displayed on the screen, so that screen can be interacted to the user. So the operations can be performed by the user, the manipulations are taken by the user itself. So that is an interactive computer graphics. So we need to understand the interactive computer graphics with a two-way communication. So the interactive communication is nothing but the two-way, that is nothing but the video games. So the video games are nothing but, so the user can operation, we take the operation, the total control is taken by the user itself on the image which are going to be played. So that's why the interactive computer graphics is taken the part of the video games, and the non-interactive computer graphics is taking the part of the TV broadcasting. So that means here user can only watch graphical activity without any interaction. That is simply we can understand in the non-interactive graphics. Non-interactive computer graphics are nothing but user can only watch a graphical activity without any interaction. Only he can visible factor is there, and he can view the content on the image which are going to be displayed on the screen only. So in the interactive computer graphics, here user can engage with the graphics. That is, it is two-way communication. So user and graphics are taking the part of the communication. So both can be active. So for example, you go to the chess game in the computer. So when the user can place one step, immediately the computer also takes one more step. So some of the manipulations are taken both sides. So both sides operations can be done. That is a two-way communication. That is an interactive computer graphics. So you need to understand the computer graphics in these two ways. One is a non-interactive computer graphics and the interactive computer graphics. So coming to the basic components of the interactive computer graphics, because we are going to learn the interactive computer graphics only, because the computer graphics can take the images and create the images and manipulate the images, and there are some operations can take place on the images or any pictures. So that means the interactive mode can be taken in this communication. That's why the two-way communications are taken. The two-way communications are takes place between the user and the computer graphics. Now, before we go to the computer graphics, so initially we can understand what the computer is, because the computer is an electronic device which accesses raw facts. So here some of the few things we need to understand before we can take the computer graphics, because the basic components in the computer graphics are also taken, the input, and second one is the processing, and third one is the display device, which is called the output. So similarly, which is related to the computers. So what the computer is? Nothing but a computer is an electronic device which access raw facts, store them, process them under the instruction given by the user or programmer. So this is what the exact definition. Here the some of the components like, so which takes the raw facts in the sense that is a raw data, original data without combined data. So before we take this particular process, we need to understand what is a data and the information. So that is a basic thing. A data is a nothing but the unprocessed factor, and where is a information is a processed factor. So a data is an unprocessed in the sense before go to the process. So whatever the data you can apply, that is an unprocessed. When it will be the execute the process of data, so that becomes to the information. Now we can consider our textbook have the information, not the data, because of our textbook giving some processed information. So processed data, that processed data is nothing but the information. Now here we can take in a computer communication in the computers. So the computer takes the input in the form of the different devices, like initially the keyboard. We know that the initial information can enter through the keyboard, and also the process can take here the CPU is the main heart of the computer. Like you can understand in the computer graphics also, so it has also one of the processor like the GPU. GPU in the sense the graphical use process unit. So here also GPU is there in the place of the CPU. Later we will discuss so what the GPU is. First we need to understand the computer. In the computer takes the input in the form of the raw facts, that is through the keyboard, and second one it process the data. How it can process the data, that is in the control unit is there, ALU is there, and the data can be stored in your memory. So that is an initial part, so where the data can be stored. So it will be the stored in the two different identification. We know that is a primary memory and the secondary memory, and the last one is, so the result will be displayed onto the screen. So whatever the information which is placed, the result displayed onto the screen. So that is the output device. Here also the computer graphics can take the computer graphics in the sense we go for the interactive computer graphics, not the non-interactive computer graphics. There is no operations can perform in the non-interactive computer graphics. That's why we are going to learn only the interactive computer graphics as two-way communication is taken place. So here also input is taken, and second one is the processing is there, and the third one is the display or the output device. So we can understand this concept more so with this diagram. Now this is an interactive conceptual diagram of interactive computer graphics. So what the conceptual diagram? Conceptual diagram means it is the process what the computer graphics contains. That means from the beginning to the ending. Beginning in the sense how it can take the input and how the input can be displayed onto the screen. This is the a major information in the interactive computer graphics. So coming to this conceptual diagram, so you can observe, so here also you take the graphic system or GPU. Here you can observe this is the GPU, so like the CPU. So in our computer we can take the CPU is a central processor unit here. So here we can consider one more graphic system is there. So before we can take this particular concept of this conceptual diagram of interactive computer graphics, the first one is the application model or database. So basically in anywhere you can use in the computer related information, so the database is looking like this. So always the database is looking like this. Okay, that is a symbolically representation of the database. So what the database is nothing but whatever the image or whatever the picture we are going to take, we are going to deliver, we are going to identify. So actually that will be stored in the database. We will take that information from the database only. So whatever the application program we are going to prepare, so that means the application program in the sense, here suppose we are going to take a drawing a picture on the screen. So actually it is not possible. It is not possible to take that picture directly to display it onto the screen. There is a particular process. So there is a particular process we have to take that image and prepare some application programs through the algorithms, and finally which can be displayed onto the screen only. So here what the concept of this particular interactive computer graphics is, whatever we are going to develop the image or any picture, first we need to take that identify that picture is available, that information is available in the database or not. For example, what the database is nothing but, so if you go to the ATM, so when we go to the ATM is nothing but having some account in the bank only, we are going to the ATM. Otherwise, we didn't go to the ATM to take the money. So here in the similar way, so if we have that particular information in the database, then only we can access it. Otherwise, we can't access the information related to that particular image. So that means initially the database should be maintained, the total information related to the computer graphics, what are the images are there, what are the identification of the images are there, everything is available on that particular database. And the next one is the application program. So whatever the image we are going to be displayed onto the screen, first we need to prepare some application program, because without application program, without preparation of that particular application program in a particular language, so we didn't display that image onto the screen. I already said one of the statement, it is not possible to take any image or any line or any picture directly onto the screen, which is not possible. There is a process, because in a interactive computer graphics, we need to take some of the manipulation operations on that particular image. That's why here we prepared some application program. So the application program is nothing but a software. It is a software or it is a program which we have to prepare related to a particular image. So the application program is prepared, and again the next identification is, suppose we have to prepare some of the functions or the procedures or any methods, any other methods related to the language, so we have to prepare those in the application program. So that application program, okay, whatever the procedure, whatever the functions, whatever the methods are used in that particular application program, all the functions or the methods should be available in the graphics library only. So without
availability of that graphics library, we can't use that particular method in the application program. So for example here you can consider in our C programming, so we can use some mathematical notation like function sqrt of x. Actually sqrt, square root function of x. So when you can use this particular square root function, if you include so one of the header file like math.h, so when you include the math.h in our hash include stdio.h, after that we can write hash include math.h, one of the header file, this will be called as an header file. So this header file is including in that particular source file, then only we can use this sqrt function. So otherwise we can't use the sqrt function. Sqrt function is used when you are using the math.h. That means sqrt function is available in the math.h. In similar manner, whatever the procedure, whatever the function, whatever the method you are using related to the application program of the image, that particular function or the method should be available in the computer graphics, that is the graphics library. So if the graphics library is once verifies, so that is a part of the software. Here in the conceptual diagram of interactive computer graphics, so have the two parts, one is the software and second one is the hardware. In between you can observe the GPU. So like computer system is also having like that. So in the display device, that is we can observe in the screen, that is a monitor, and some of the input devices like keyboard and so on, and the CPU contains some of the software which can be loaded for developing the application program. So here in the last one is the hardware. Hardware is the display device. So whatever the image you are going to prepare, you are prepared that image can be displayed onto the screen. But here you may be observed that graphic system or the GPU is act as an interface between the software and the hardware. So in the software related term, one of the criteria goes to the OS, so the operating system. So what the operating system is, nothing but it is an interface between user program and the hardware of the system. So here similarly, the user programs are nothing but the software. User programs are nothing but the software. So we have to prepare the user program and to interacted with the computer graphics, that is with the help of the a graphic system is there. Without graphic system, that's why if you go through that computer in a normal computer, so how the voice can be delivered to the outside is nothing but some graphic card is loaded in that particular system. If the graphics card is not available, so then the record of the voice, record of the images or anything, which is not possible. So that means likewise here in the conceptual diagram of the conceptual framework of this particular interactive computer graphics, one of the system is needed, that is the graphic system or the GPU. So this is the a main part in the computer graphics, that is particularly the interactive computer graphics. It takes all the programs related application programs of the a particular graphics, and which can be taken and the process in the graphic system, and whatever the content is displayed to the output, that will be passed to the hardware only. Here whatever the software role is there, the hardware role is also the similar, because here one thing we can remember before we go through this complete concept of the computer graphics, because of whatever we are preparing the software, which is a compulsory developed or understood by the hardware itself. Without understanding by the hardware, so the software or the application program cannot be executed, and finally which is not displayed the image onto the screen only. So when it will be the image displayed onto the screen is nothing but the software should be compatible with the hardware only. So if the compatible is taken, then only the picture or the image can be displayed onto the screen. So that means we have to take here the reliability between the application, that is the software, and related to the hardware. So here we can understand the graphic system or the GPU is an interface between
the user program, that is the software, and the hardware. So what is the computer graphics? A computer graphics is the is used by the computer system to create or manipulate the image which is displayed onto the screen. And one more is, based on this diagram, we will add one of the statement. It comprises the software technology of, it comprises the software technology to create, to modify, or to manipulate, or to represent that image onto the screen. Here also the four factors can be defined based on this diagram of interactive computer graphics. What the four factor is? Nothing but, so it comprises of software technology to create. What create? Whatever the image, whatever the diagram you are going to create. So with the help of the computer software only. That's why it comprises the software technology to create or to modify or to store. One more is the store, is store nothing but the event you have to consider in the computer graphics. It is a store and forward method. So that's why, so the image can be created, the image can be modified, the image can be stored, and the image can be represented. So these are the four aspects which are identified through this diagram. So where it can be stored, already database is there, maintains there some database. So whatever we want, whatever we can communicate, we just take that image or a picture onto the picture from the database. So that means it can be stored in the location of the database. And second one, we can observe the first one, the create. How to create that one? That is already I explained through the application program only. So we have to create something on the screen. So we need to create some image with the help of the application program. And second one, we can modify the program with the help of the graphic system. So that means some of the operations which are performed by the user, which are taken from the graphics library, and the graphics library gives the list of some of the functions or the any procedure related to the modification of the a particular application or the image. So here also create the image and the store the image and the modify or any operations perform on that particular image. And the final one is the representation of the image. How the image can be represented? That image can be represented onto the screen. That is the hardware of the computer. So finally the computer screen, okay, can display whatever the image can forwarded by the user, okay, through the GPU system or the graphic system, that is directly displayed onto the screen. So this is the very fundamental concept of the interactive computer graphics. So we understand what is the computer graphics, and second one is the types of computer graphics are the two: interactive computer graphics and non-interactive computer graphics. Non-interactive computer graphics are nothing but the one-way process. So that is, example is the television broadcasting. So there is no operations performed by the user, okay, whatever the image, whatever the picture is going to telecast. So just he can view the content only. And in the second part is the interactive computer graphics. In interactive computer graphics, all the operations are taken by the user itself. So that means there is some interaction with the computer graphics and the user. So in the next session, we are going to discuss what are the display devices, what are the input devices, and what are the display related monitors like CRT and the color CRT monitor, and so on in the next video.